You have probably already heard of a Jacob's ladder before. In today's video, I'm gonna tell you how to build one and how they actually work. So let's go. This is my setup. We basically have two microwave oven transformers with the primaries wired in parallel and the secondaries wired in series. Basically, I've connected the two cores together and then I've phased them as such that the output voltage on these two high voltage terminals add up. So we get about 4 kilovolt out of these two transformers. Then for each transformer, we have a pair of microwave oven capacitors. And then the output from the capacitors go through the 16 kilovolt wires to the Jacob's ladder. In this project, we have high voltages and especially very, very high currents. So be very cautious when working with this kind of system, because this transformer pair with the capacitors and everything is absolutely lethal. Now this is the most important part of any Jacob's ladder, and that is the bottom of the ladder where the arc first starts. And in this case, since the voltage is just about 4000 volts and can't jump such a great distance here, we have a candle. Because what the candle does, since fire is a conductive plasma, the fire of the candle flame helps the electricity to jump this gap, because the entire candle flame is basically conductive. And there's another interesting thing that happens, and that is under the electric field between these two electrodes, the flame spreads apart and then touches these wires here. And like that, the first arc is formed. After an arc is formed down here at the bottom of the Jacob's ladder, the arc starts to heat up the air around it because it's extremely hot. And as you know, hot air rises. And the hot rising air then takes the arc with it and basically draws it upwards until it breaks at the top of the Jacob's ladder. Because at the top here, the distance is too great for the arc to jump over, and it becomes much easier to jump over at the bottom again where the candle is. And like that, the cycle repeats and the arc goes upwards, breaks, and starts at the bottom again. As I stated before, this Jacob's ladder is extremely dangerous, so let me show you what would happen if you accidentally touched it by showing you what it does to this pickle. Now a last thing before I go, and that is that soon I'm gonna be making a video on this transformer right here. And if any one of you knows how this thing is called, please write it down in the comments. I'm really interested to see if any one of you knows how this thing is called. And yeah, until then, stay safe, keep exploring science, and thank you for watching. This was Science by Sacho, and I'm out. Goodbye.